All right. NA branch again. Let me go ahead and put the prediction up. It's going to be a very similar round, guys. Wait a minute. Oh, no, it's not. Interesting. So, start prediction. It's the opposite. I see what they're doing now. Go ahead, put that on for, we'll do 20. All right, let me edit my command here because I thought it was a rerun, but it's not. It's the opposite. And let's see, green 4, it's blue 4 now. Is Rush attacking 3 green 4 terminals? There we go. Edited that command slightly. So this is going to look similar to the previous AO in the sense that it's actually identical. But now blue 4 is the one attacking this sector. So that's really cool for a bit to flip flop like that. But otherwise, let's go ahead and go over things. So again, similar to the NAEU round in terms of AOs, but things are flip flopped. So now blue 4 has, you know, the attack capability. So I find that quite interesting for this round to go. But otherwise, let's go ahead and go through our brief. Just for fun, simple rush mission. Lots of 4 to 5 points, which is reversible and will be played both ways, so to speak. So that's what it meant for the previous round. It pits two factions making their debut in FNF against each other. The Balkan League, Green 4, and the Polish Special Forces, Blue 4, who are fighting in Finland because of reasons. All right, so different factions here too. This is a rush attack, so that means the terminals have to be taken in order. The hack time for the terminals is going to be 90 seconds long, and only Terminal 1 can be hit. Once Terminal 1 is hit, then Terminal 2 will be attacked, and then Terminal 3 will be attacked once they go through. Otherwise, variable settings, 50-minute safe start round, 50 minutes for the full round in itself. Max view distance is going to be kilometer, no magnified optics nor NVG equipment, and then the builder points for defending is 300. To give you some comparison here, normally it's 125 per round, but it's nearly tripled. Medium anti-tank settings, both sides get 2 rounds of AT per launcher, no HE rounds. Blue 4 is going to be fielding the MOZ, Op 4 is going to be fielding the RPG-32. Blue 4, as they said, it is basically Polish Special Forces here, so a really nice set of kits here. They're going to be using the Remington ACRs, both the main rifle and the carbine version, the Glock 17 as the handgun. You have a Mini-Me and an MG3 as the light machine gun and medium machine gun, respectively. The M72 Law as the light anti-tank, an M24 for the sniper, and then for the suppressed shooters, a choice between the Mark 14 or the MP5 integrally suppressed SD version. And then crew and aviation get a choice of a carbine ACR or an MP5A4 variant. Nothing in crew served weapons. Otherwise, they get 2 transport trucks, 3 transport cars, the 1117 with its GMG rescripted to a 7.62 coax instead, and they still have the 12.7 gun. And then you have your 3 M240 Humvees. So I'm just adjusting the light levels in this room real quick. All right, cool. Now we're going to go ahead and look to Op 4, which has no data because Op 4... Actually, no, before we even do that, there's 2 things we got to look at. One, I'll do the roster breakdown, but number 2... I want to see what their marksman weapon is, but I'll get to that in a second. So Mountain is going to be commanding Blue 4 on this side. And then Pinoy Power, a.k.a. Falcon. Interesting. Is Falcon playing tonight? 1 second. Yeah, I think... Yeah. So he's playing under a different name, but Falcon is back. All right. So he's playing as the platoon medic here. Yeah, it's definitely Falcon wiggling up there on the top, and that is his symbol on the shoulder to represent his clan. All right, so Falcon's on tonight. interestingly enough. Otherwise, Kevin's going to be leading the X-ray group, Colin as the group's medic, Olaf as the sniper, Bacon Flavored Ivan, I believe, as the 2IC. And no, wait a minute. Spikey's the 2IC. Fez and Bacon Flavored Ivan are taking the Mark 14s that are suppressed because I saw EBR on his back. That was a little interesting. Otherwise, then we got Falcon jumping around right there. Otherwise, Montgomery leading Alpha with G-Legs and Gordon taking a vehicle crew slot. They're probably going to take the M117. Shulin leading Alpha 1 with Schultz, Bates, Carlson, Despo, Puma, and Brady under him. Alpha 2 with Jareek leading Martin, Maz, Anderson, Cosmonaut, Vagrant, and Poe under him. Xandu leading Bravo HQ. He's formed everyone up in his group. So he's got Hood, Selwick, Killer Wolf, Funny Man, Black Fox, Ralph, and Shagium with him, and then Bravo 1, who's probably going to merge with him as well, Rob Wolf acting as a second medic. Now, real quick, I'm going to click through because I'm trying to see what their marksman rifle is. Yeah, they have their weapons lowered, so I'm not going to be able to do it that way. So I'm looking for like an ACR with a magnified optic, because these are all CCO-68 sights. We got a holograph sight, which are just simple red dots. But I don't see anything there. Let's go ahead and look under Alpha 2 here, because I'm just curious what their marksman rifle is. I don't see a marksman rifle there, so let's check Alpha 1. And nope, that's a holograph sight. Okay, yeah, so it's just going to be an ACR with a RCO. So basically, marksman rifles are going to be the same weapon, a 5.56 ACR instead. All right, cool. That answers all of my questions. Let's go ahead and look over at Green 4 here. So Green 4 is going to, let's look at their gear first, the fictional Balkan Defense League. Why do I recognize the name from somewhere? Is that a Ace Combat faction with the Balkan Witchcraft? Is that where I know those memes from? I've never played an Ace Combat game. It's just every time I make an Ace Combat meme, because I know of it, people always bring up Balkan Witchcraft. So I'm assuming that's it. Someone feel free to correct me in chat, though, because I could be wrong. Otherwise, they have AKMs with Zentico sights, so they can use Western rails. That's Belka. My bad. All right, so I don't know what Balkan then is. I was close. I'm sorry to say that I was getting that wrong, but wow, okay, they have a lot of weaponry here. So either AKMs with Zentico sights, Colt carbines, or M16A3s. PM handguns are the secondary. RPK is the light machine gun. PKP is the medium machine gun, excuse me. Balkan is a region. It's part of East Europe, former Yugoslavia. Got it. All right, thanks, guys. Sorry, I got those terms confused. Hope I didn't offend anyone. Otherwise, light anti tank is going to be the M136. Recon is going to get the 338 T5000. It's chambered in 338. But otherwise, we have the choice of the AKS or the ASL. And then the crew and aviation get a choice of the PP2000 submachine gun, which is just, you know, the future PPSH, or a Colt carbine. Nothing in crew served weapons. They get two CAMAS transport trucks, three transport UAZs, two GAZs with PKTs, a BTR-80, and a GAZ Vodnik. We'll check their marksman rifle in a second. Let's check their group. Tender Banner is going to be leading. Flux is going to be the platoon medic. Savan going to be leading X-Ray. Nemesis as the medic for the group. Lennox being the sniper. Lurch being the 2IC. Mito taking an AKS. And Jabi taking an AKS as well. Ilbanek leading Alpha HQ here. He's got Patriot and Artisan being a vehicle crew for the BTR-80. Good Time Saddam leading Alpha 1 with Holton, Mike, Azuki, Mackenzie, Atanius, and Michael under him. I'm going to quickly click through these again. So their marksman rifle is going to be an SVD. That's fair. 10 rounds, 7.62x5.4. Interesting choice. Otherwise, Banks leading Swola, Band, Fred, Guy Fieri, Schnuffles, and Dooley. Charlie leading, being led by Steve with Appa, Mittens, Meldon, Kabooie Face, McAce. I always get his name wrong. Kabooie Face Ace. I never get that right. I just call him Kabooie. And I still forget the second B. Resent My Love, Waldo, and Pierce also all together. Now, you're going to notice there's only about 75 people on, give or take. This is some of the lowest numbers we have seen in FNF in a long time. And I've been saying this in some of my other streams. I'm noticing a lot of communities are having dips in players right now. I think that just has to do with people traveling around. So we'll see how that all works out. But regardless, It means we're going to see some smaller scale stuff with FNF, and it also means that the rounds are probably going to go a bit quicker. I don't think we had a single round in the EU branch that went to the full time. They were getting up there, you know, at the 40-minute mark, but out of the full 50 minutes, I don't think any of them went past 40. We did get to the 50-minute warning a few times, but it was usually finished up very close after that was called. So we'll probably see, you know, 30, 40-minute rounds. Maybe it'll extend further, but with the smaller player bases, I doubt it. So otherwise, let's go ahead and look at the terminal site. So this is Terminal 1. Terminal 1 appears to be the exact markers on the corner of a building here. I just can't seem to find it. It should theoretically be in that corner? No? In the barn? In the barn. I am just silly. So this AO is really nice. It's got a lot of open fields you can knock, lock down. But the one caveat is there's high ground over here that people can get on top of. I think we've had an AO in this section in the past, actually. I feel like we have. I could just be a similar area in Viralati. But otherwise, yeah, taking these open areas would be easy. It's just the difficulty is holding this forested area. Blue 4 can deploy over here, send their guys forward, have their 1117 cover from afar through these open areas. Please pardon me. And pretty much lock down the rest of that area. Terminal 2 looks like that's where a majority of their vehicles have spawned, but Green 4 is going all infantry. They gotta be careful though, because Blue 4 can come and steal these, but really I think that would just be helpful for Blue 4's sake to get to other terminal sites and have more firepower. But the terminal site is right in here again, lots of open area. This forested part though, they can also fortify, but I would say this is a better AO than that because it doesn't have that massive open area going around, but we'll see how things go. Falcon poking me, saying Arma physics are at my bitch today. STG. Forget what that stands for. But regardless, I just can launch myself off of a trash can. Yeah, beautiful. You can do a lot with enhanced movement glitching, as we see Flux also doing the same thing. I love how Flux is the platoon medic for Green 4 and Falcon's the platoon medic for Blue 4, and they're both doing enhanced movement glitching right now. They're literally just mirroring each other, which I find kind of funny. But anyway, Terminal 3 over yonder. Another really great AO, lots of open area. Just a little bit of a forested position, some buildings off to the side, but yeah, they can also easily lock down that position too. But I appreciate they're developing this AO with the intent to fall back. But I'm going to be honest, I think out of all the AOs, 2 is the best because you got some building cover to work with here. And then you can fortify the slight high ground forested area as well and really just lock down whatever comes towards you. Now, here's the thing, though. The difference here is that it's only a 70-player match, so there's going to be, like, you know, 30 v 40 in some of these matches here. So the defenders who have to fight against number advantages on the attacker side have to be very, very picky with how they split their forces and how they set up their defenses and how they mount any attacks or counterattacks based off of what the attacking faction does. Whereas all the attackers need to do is keep their force together in any form of unified battle line, and they should be able to smash through any tiered defenses that the defenders come up with. Falcon, Jesus Christ. Who else but Falcon? I'm going to write that one down. And there he's doing it again. Freaking goober. Well, yeah, Falcon is a bird. So, again, there's no surprise there. So he's getting on this trash can, and he just flew over there. So is he enhanced movementing into the trash can? Yeah, that's exactly what he's doing. Okay. All right. Sure. Sure. Falcon's being a literal bird. Don't you love Arma physics? All you need is enhanced movement and a trash can, and you too can fly like Falcon. I'll admit to you guys, so I've been trying to separate my highlights out across everything I've done with an FNF, just for the sake of being able to make the highlight compilations a little more quickly, because I'm trying to release one or two a week, but I haven't been true to that, because to organize at least 150 clips that I already had is a bit of a pain in the butt. I'm going to be honest, I probably have more than 150 in there, probably more like 200 to 300, but I digress. I have a folder dedicated to Falcon, because Falcon does so much dumb shit on his own that he literally warrants a folder. And he just flew so far, he just went out of that AO, but good God. 2 minutes to go for this mission. If I were to bet on anyone, I'd honestly bet Blue 4, because that 1117, I would argue, is the deadliest vehicle for its class within Friday Night Fights. Because compared to BTRs with the 14.5mm, Blue 4 has double the ammo of its anti-material machine gun in the form of the 100-round boxes for the M2. And it's just much more of a threat. It's an incredibly mobile piece of equipment. There's just so much you can do with it. But, and then with all these massive open areas, I'd imagine the gunner. I mean, and then there we got G-Legs and Gordon. G-Legs is gunning, though. So he's definitely one of the more fearful gunners to look out for. I would say the only other combos of vehicles I see deadlier is people like Bay and Falcon together, or Bay and Dooley. Now, this isn't to say that's a guarantee, though, because we got Bay on the enemy side. We got elements of Papega on the enemy side. We have elements of Scandi Recon on the other side, but they're playing defense. So I take points away on bets for Scandi and Papega playing defense as minimal elements, because I'm going to be honest, their offense game is much better than their defense game. And it actually kind of plays against Papega, because Papega is too aggressive to play defense, in my opinion. And they're off. Oh, bumper car. Thankfully, they didn't desync into each other. That would have been bad. Ah, and of course, some of you are betting on the opposite of what I say, because every time I try to give you a recommendation, well, not every time, two-thirds of the time, the other team ends up winning. So, yeah, all right, by all means. We'll see. We'll see, guys. Now, I want to calibrate my render distance here to Alpha HQ. Their view distance is about a kilometer, so back behind Alpha HQ, that forested area, that's about 800 meters, so that would be a kilometer. All right, because I want to give the same view distance that the players have according to the mission info. Just so I can be accurate in showing you what the players can see on the ground. So I'd imagine Blue 4 are going to try to come up here to deploy in the forested route and head south. Green 4 has predicted this, and they're sending elements of X-Ray down to potentially deal with this group. So we're going to see a quick deployment here and contact almost immediately, because X-Ray is going to be right on top of this position anyhow. I hear the BTR firing. No, that's the 1117 firing. Is it? Yes. So 1117 has spotted infantry up on the hills here and is trying to surgically pick them off. That's a mushroom. I thought that was a blood splatter of someone getting hit, but that is not the case here. So that's forces holding the in-between area between Sector 2 and 3 to pull back. BTR, though, is behind cover. If the BTR gets a good shot at that KPVT turret, it will tear that 113 apart. Just needs a little bit of coordination. No defense has won today. You're right. All of EU, there were no defensive victories. I can't believe I missed that. You are completely right, 418. Damn, and I'm supposed to be the stupid analyst here. Yep, and there's the 14.5 cooking that engine off. Driver is dead. That's the one thing about the 1117 is you need to use its high level of mobility. If you stick it and the KPVT gets a few shots on your engine, you're dead. Ooh. And they just cooked off the fuel tank. Well, wow. I know, because I've bet defense every round. Oh, buddy, I'm sorry to hear that. All right, X-Ray, I think, just took a casualty for... No, they did not. Okay. They've just divided up around here. So you got Nemesis down over here. Seven trying to fire GLs over. They're landing a little to the right. Are these the two suppressed shooters? Yes, they are, with AKSs. They're in a great flanking position, and they could do a serious amount of damage here if they are slow to maneuver. But they got to be careful, because Blue 4 X-Ray is also coming around in a front-on-front fight. I don't know. The suppressed guns between the usual Op 4 choices, the AKS and the AS Val, I never see them work well. Yeah, best vehicle in FNF immediately gets shredded. I know. When I explain what I see, the game likes to prove me wrong. So Kevin took a few hits. Colin's looking in this direction. He should spot that movement. Yep, immediately starts firing at Jabby. Doesn't get the kill. Grenades have been buffed, by the way. That could kill him. It does not. When you go prone against a grenade, it usually lets you live. Usually. That should have blown his head off in reality, but that's forcing these guys to pull back. You got some suppressive fire coming in from the 240 Bravos here. X-Ray blindly suppressing back as Blue 4 Alpha fires past the smoke, trying to get a lead on Green 4 here. Sven takes a bullet and gets shot in the back. Nemesis could throw a smoke grenade, pick Sven up and move him back if he notices, but he is busy trying to suppress at this point. He goes prone, gets caught in the ragdoll, and a grenade blows him up, and Nemesis immediately runs. And another grenade takes out Nemesis! Oh, see? They buffed grenades, and I love them so much. I know, what's that? There's your proof right there. They finally buffed grenades to what they're supposed to be. And it's great. It's honestly great. See? It's awesome! GL's actually, like, hurt people now. And there's another one. And there goes the sniper. Yeah, two GLs would probably kill a person, right? Meanwhile, I think Mito is the last guy on the X-Ray team. Yeah. So Jabby, the other suppressed shooter, got picked off. And Blue 4 is now encircling this position. And it's being led by Maz. So Maz is the main, not main mission maker, but he's the guy that makes all of the units. And for me to further explain it, he got the kill, by the way. I'll just click this button. I'll click this button, this button. Yeah. I'll click this button. Yeah. He makes all of the loadouts for the infantry. And as far as I know, he's the only one that does it. Like, Santa, you get a GL, you get a GL. You mean Oprah, then. Everybody gets a GL. But it actually gives fear to explosions again, because you used to be able to tank so much grenade fire. It was really, really random if you actually died to a grenade, even, like, full stand. You would take damage, but you wouldn't die. You wouldn't get knocked unconscious. That was a rare sight. Now, you'll actually die if you don't hit the deck and look away. And even then, if the grenade is close enough to you, like within a meter or two, you will probably die. As it's supposed to be. I wouldn't say they buffed nades. I honestly want to say they removed the debuff from grenades, because implying they buffed it means they made it more powerful from the basis of what it was in the first place. But we need to build the basis off of General Arma 3, and FNF did not use grenades like General Arma 3 does, you know? Like the average base game. So we can... I'm just going to say they reset the damage. They made them normal again. Ooh, G-Leg's got it working, and there's still fuel in it, even though the fuel must have been flamed off, because he was able to adjust it. Now he's trying to use it as a mobile sniper rifle to pick off people on buildings. BTR, meanwhile, has gone all the way over here with the intent on ambushing Blue 4 as they cross. Not a bad call, but now that 14.5mm that's used to snipe those vehicles isn't going to be helpful in taking that Vic out. So, what's that? I'm going to be honest with you. I actually like that for PvP, the fact that they made all of the vests an equivalent amount of armor, because for balancing's sake, you kind of need that, because otherwise whoever has the more powerful, like anyone that played Russian factions would automatically win, because Russian body armor is the most overpowered thing in, you know, RHS. So I know you like to bitch about that, but in my opinion, that's a good change. The only thing that they don't balance is vehicles. They have their own balance for it. I disagree with it. I see the logic that they try to follow with it, but it's interesting, to say the least. Oh, sorry, what's that? You always harbor on that point, though, so I've just assumed you have a problem on it, because I read everything you say in your tone of voice. Ooh, great headshot side there. Ilbanek also went down. OG Lake slowly picking people up, but what's that's one of those people where he just always sounds angry. Or annoyed. Annoyed is the better term, not angry. All right, we now got Blue 4 coming in this big open area. And I think the BTR knows it. It needs to wait till they're a little more in the open and then they can blow them all up. Problem was nerfing the explosives and nades. Yeah, so that's been redone. So now it's as it should be. Vehicle balance, I don't think they're ever going to fix because they're very adamant about their version of balance. Which, again, it's their community. They can do what they want with that. Same with grenade damage. But, you know, grenades being a usable feature now is quite nice. Perpetually disappointed. You're right. Yep, that would be it. But it's funny because we've seen, I think, one or two bad frags already where the person actually blows themselves up, which is fair in a bad frag situation. And that was during the EU wrench today, so. Fury's bleeding a little bit. You're hearing that 12.7 starting to fire because they smoked this area. Not sure if they spotted the BTR or whatnot. It's trying to hit Vagrant with that 14.5mm. That's going to force Blue 4 to pull around here instead. I'm going to take a quick look at the casualty list. Blue 4 has lost 3 people so far. Green 4 has lost the entirety of their X-ray and one defender by Ilvanek's position. So it's in Blue 4's ballpark at the moment, but both vehicles on Overwatch can do a lot of damage otherwise. Yeah, and I agree with you, what's that? So they've got AT out and they're going that way, which to me indicates they've identified the BTR over here and they're trying to get a medium anti-tank weapon to fire. Anderson! Landing short. The BTR now is reacting to it. A little slow. Puts a random round out there, maybe to clear out the box to reload the KPTV. Here's what I'm really excited for though, because explosive specialist in the squad, you get a choice of 4 different items. 3 AT mines, 2 tripwire HE mines, and 2 tripwire flare mines. They've come in the same package. So again, the 3 AT mines or those 4 mines, 2 AP anti-personnel, 2 as protection. 4 explosive charges or 2 explosive satchels, and you convert them to throwable units. A little bit of friendly fire right there. But the caveat here is since they have reset how explosive damage works, so it's now normal compared to the rest of the base game, I want to see tripwire mines work in the fullest extent of what they're designed to do, because now they will actually kill you. In the past, they usually just knock you to your feet by crippling your leg. Now, with damage being the way it is now, it should kill you. So I think these guys had a stick of light anti-tank. I don't see the tube, but some sort of AT was fired over here. Might have been against the 240 Humvee here and miss. But these guys are kind of screwed because there's no way for them to pull back now. Meanwhile, BTR's come out and G-Legs is trying to shoot it out. They're popping the smoke cover here. But the Vic was able to get out of there relatively unscathed. So Platoon HQ is driven around. They might get a dedicated driver for G-Legs because they have a +2 in there. So I think the guy in the shotgun seat's going to get out and drive the Vic. Yep. No, the shotgun seat's not going to drive that. And Falcon's going to drive the Vic. Oh, dear. So Falcon being on tonight. We'll see how that goes. X-Ray has now come around to do a wide flank. And Blue 4 is now starting to get right on top of this position where Green 4 has their defense line. So I said earlier, this is probably, if not, going to be the assault direction that Blue 4 picks. 3-4's got some decent flanking spots on some of the sides, though. The BTR was locking down the other position, but was forced to pull back after taking AT. This could swing either way. Because with Blue 4 being so clumped up around a single assault wave, a few well-placed grenades is going to be all you need. Same caveat here. Green 4 is also on a thin strip of defensive area. So a few well-placed grenades by Blue 4 is all they need. See, I don't think they should be pulling back like this because this puts them in low ground for GL fire to easily pick them off. They should be waiting for Blue 4 to get right on top of their position, pop grenades by a frag, and then smoke, and then pull back. Because now you got Maz getting on top of his position. But Ilbanek bitch slaps him back. Wow. Oh. The disrespect. Now, let me explain how Ilbanek won that firefight. Ilbanek was on a higher position. And what that means is the first thing when you look down to engage the target is going to be the person's head. Whereas if Maz looks up to the target, he's going to be looking at the player's feet and then looking up and firing at the leg center mass. So it takes one bullet to hit the person's face to kill them in Arma. But it takes another grenade went off, killed a dude. But it takes multiple shots to the center mass area, the legs and torso, to kill them. That's how Ilbanek was able to turn and make that shot real quick, because he immediately was put at Maz's center mass, which was the head. We're seeing some explosive charges being thrown. Grenade right in Ralph's face, blowing him to unconsciousness. He might still wake back up from that, though. More explosive being thrown. That was another charge, I bet. The caveat about charges, though, is you can only throw them at like a third to fourth of the distance, depending on if it's a charge or a satchel. So it's meant to be something you literally like run up to a fortification, throw that over, and then you haul your ass back. Because compared to RGOs and RGNs, RGNs are offensive grenades that you can throw really far but have a smaller explosion. And then RGO grenades are defensive grenades that you don't throw as far but they have a bigger explosion. So your RGOs are meant to be thrown over like HESCO barriers and shit, so it gets right behind the HESCO and detonates, whereas your RGNs are meant to be like, you know, in forests, open areas that you need to throw far to get them into position. I also love GLs, UGL specifically, because even regular GLs, so grenade launcher and underbarrel grenade launcher, all the GL fire you're gonna be seeing is from UGLs technically, but they knock over trees, which is really funny to watch. But look at all this smoke coming from both smoke grenades and UGLs. Chult taking some flanking fire here, forced to get pinned under a tree. And now you have the BTR that has come up. And G-Legs has been knocked unconscious. Falcon getting out to get behind cover. But yeah, now the damage texture's right there. He pulls out his body. I don't know why G-Legs was naked. I'm not going to ask. But the BTR is now going to be able to flank and eliminate that triple 1-7. And we're still seeing defenders hold here. Black Fox is not waking up from that grenade throw. Ilbanek gets wounded and eliminated by that grenade. Blue 4 has been kept up in the forest here. They've been taking a lot more casualties now, but Green 4 have also been receiving quite a bit, including their medic for the platoon level has been hit. But Green 4 still have another squad out there, and they also have the BTR marauding. So that compared to Blue 4 throwing all their forces here except for X-Ray is why you see such a massive number difference. Shuffle's trying to flank Vagrant, but Vagrant gets shot by Fred. And Swollig with some follow-up shots as well. Anderson trying to pick off. Oh, he's firing up here at the fortified area where the marksmen are. There is one guy dead up here. Guy Fieri taking a few hits as well. Ilbanek wakes back up. He's on two kills. Finds Bates crawling up to him. Cosmonaut now blindly spraying. Ilbanek spraying back. Cosmonaut coming around. Tries to fire a GL. I think that would have been within the minimum debt distance anyway, so it wouldn't have even gone off if it hit close enough. Ilbanek climb it and look around. But Cosmonaut's trying to flank. He spots him. Takes him out. That's Ilbanek on four kills. I think the defense might actually win this round. Compared to the offense lost one every round in NA. Or excuse me, the EU branch. Anderson getting taken out by Schnuffles. That was his first kill. Ilmenek on four, Michael on none, Dooley on one, Guy Fieri on three. Those guys are on none, but there's been a lot of casualties, so I'm curious to know where those attacks are coming from. Michael just got knocked out, possibly by a friendly fire. And you still hear that BTR firing. Looks like they abandoned the 1117. And the Humvee got its engine shot out, so now these guys are pinned in here. So they can reload the KPTV and just tear apart that barn and hope for some kills. But they might not because they want to save their ammo instead. But they've also been using quite a few boxes. Ilmenek tries counterattacking. Yeah, that worked out as well as you would have expected. Ilmenek, you got to play defense when you're defending, buddy. Otherwise, bad things happen. That grenade might kill you. It's so satisfying to see grenades do their fucking jobs. I'm not going to lie. And then the ragdolls that they create, how they throw bodies around. It's just so fun to watch. We got the RPK here. It's an intense amount of fire coming down from this flanking position. Now we got Fred and Schnuffles coming around. Firing from the rear. Thomas goes out. They're trying to take out Alex here. Xandu turned around as Schnuffles gets behind a bush. Fred's still up. Grenades being thrown. Oh, beautiful grenade. Double kill. See, it's so exciting because grenades are actually amazing now. And we get to showcase how awesome these grenades are. Yeah, I know, Ilmenek, you tried. He also might have explosive charges and satchels because he is the explosive specialist, so I'm curious to see what he might throw. Then again, he might have already thrown them earlier because I was seeing some charges thrown. I think I only saw two, though, so he might have two more, but he can blow up that Humvee with it. You got to be careful, though, because every time you throw a satchel or a charge, great pickoff by Fred there, it makes a beep-beep sound. Killer Wolf, are you keyholing Fred or are you shooting Ralph? He's shooting Ralph. Oh, and Fred getting caught out by Killer Wolf and Ralph. He's trying to come around. I think Killer Wolf realized that Ralph was a friendly. But now Green 4 outnumber Blue 4 for the most part. You got X-Ray riding around. This is going to be a long round because X-Ray is going to stay back there trying to back cap, but they're going to be completely useless. So you do get 4 players plus a team kill. Ooh, sorry to hear that, buddy. Despo is about to be Killery Clinton by Dooley. Okay, well, it wasn't a full Killery Clinton, but yeah. And then did Bane just shoot Dooley? Huh. Wait a minute. Schult coming in. And then he gets cut down by Swola's machine gun. And Alec finishes him off. So Blue Force mounting up in this Humvee here. Gunner just got shot. Holton trying to pick off the driver there. Blind fire by Ralph. Freaks Holton out, makes him pull back. Blue 4 managed to get their vehicles repaired here and are pushing with them. Oh, baby. Holton pushing. Michael coming around as well. There goes Ralph. And Blue 4 is trying to push their Humvee in. We're only 22 minutes in the round. It's mostly over. They hit a sandbag. And Dooley has a Thing of Light anti-tank. I wonder what he'll use it for. You forgot to prep it. Shoot it. Huh. Look at that. Well, Killer Wolf becomes the Killed Wolf. And Funny Man has reinforcements coming in, but Atanius has found the Funny Man. No, Funny Man has found the Atanius. It's a rush. Swola finds the Funny Man. All right, chat. Did you just kill yourself? That's the second time that's happened tonight where someone kills themselves with their own AT. That's the second time. Ooh, G-Legs gets killed off in the 117. And Dooley bitch slaps Falcon. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. Double taps going on to Falcon by Dooley. Ghost out here trying to look around to see where he got hit from. As he's suppressed from a different angle because they saw that vehicle drive into there. Holton's getting friendly fire, tries the friendly wiggle. And there goes that guy. And now the only people left are X-Ray, who are just gonna stay on the edge of the map and drain 27 minutes. I mean, that's pretty much the end of the round here. You're gonna have the next 10 to 15 minutes dedicated to X-Ray just walking around. I hope Malin tells them to hurry up, because otherwise X-Ray is just gonna painfully like flank around being useless. Pete, oh my God, no. No way. It's the dream. It's the freaking dream. I stand corrected. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Did he get enough bandages on him to wake up again? I doubt it. Oh, man. The Falcon carry. 3 kills. No! Guys, I have a dream. He's a medic, so he's self-bloodbagged. That's how he's able to wake up. He can fully repair, heal himself. And there's only 25 minutes left, so he's got all the time in the world. He's got 3 defenders. He's got a BTR outside. And they can't ban him because he's not lone wolfing. He's literally the only guy alive in the AO. This is the perfect Falcon situation. Oh. If he can take Terminal 1, X-Ray can get on top of Terminal 2. I don't think he's going to do it, though. There's a BTR right there. He just has to kill Tenderbaner. Whenever I hype something up in Friday Night Fights, the opposite happens. It's called Caster Curse, and it's some of the funniest shit I do on this channel. he's in chat now. Oh my God, that was great. What are you actually doing? What are you doing? He almost runs his teammate over. Oh, they hit Alec! You're not allowed to technically do that! But they might not have seen him. And honestly, they were driving like a bunch of idiots. They almost ran over Bacon, too. Swola! Oh, God. No, no friendly fire. No friendly fire. Oh, please. Lag switch. Did you see him desync a little to the side like that? And then he gets Colin. Oh my God, Swola, chill. All right, Jesus. That just happened. He's on 5 kills. Well. And now you got these two chuckleheads going, should we go in there? Nah, we're just gonna chill under this tree. Okay. Yeah. FNF! Oh my god. Last two people in the AO. Sniper team, they're just chilling outside the AO. They watch their whole team die. Yep. Welcome to Friday Night Fights. Prepare for 22 minutes of pure excitement. Yes! Yes, they called it! They called it! Yes! Oh! FNF actually had the balls to call it. I can't believe it. Wow! And then the admin stating should have moved. I love it. Wow. I can't believe that happened. r/not my job. Santa Gasta in Argentina. All right, guys. We are going to play another intermission. We'll be back right... I can't play another intermission for 3 minutes. Well, thank you, game. I appreciate it, I guess. Well, I want to say BS. I headshotted you, tender. You. All right. Blue 4 doesn't win. You're right. I said the attackers would probably win. Oh, well. All right, well, let's start changing our commands up as I wait for the 2 minute 30 thing to count down. I'm always wrong, apparently. I don't know. I analyze FNF, I know what's gonna happen, and then the opposite happens. Why? Because screw me. Screw me. All right. This is gonna be round two. And let's go ahead and look at what we have planned for round two here. So it is going to be destroy objective, blue 4 attacking green 4. Are we going to see any op 4 this week? Good God. He's attacking to blue 4. Wait, no. It's blue 4 attacking, right? Yeah. Attacking to green 4 caches. Blue 4 has a 10% numbers advantage. SA, that's supposed to be SOG. Okay. The 10% numbers advantage to Venom Gun Ships. One armed, and two SOG Humvees. One with an M2, one with an M134. Minigun. Green 4 has whatchamacallit. What does Green 4 have to counter this? Wow. That's okay. Alright. A BRDM, two M2 techies, an Igla chair, manpad, static. All right, I'll believe it. And I have a third link for the multi. I'm not going back into the Discord to change it, though. I'm only changing it on our multi page. And that should be done. Cool, that is added. And we're going through our intermission. Ah, screw it. I'm already on this page, so I might as hell edit it on that. just because I already have it open, so I'm fine with that. All right, now I will be right back 1 second, because I gotta put some stuff away. Ludwig accidentally bought 2 pizzas from Costco instead of 1, so I'm gonna put the 2 in the fridge. So I'll be back in a moment. You know, I have never had one of the Costco chicken bakes. It just never looked appealing to me. I usually go for the hot dog and drink combo for $1.50. I'm going to be honest. Inflation checking is checking the prices at Costco. Because if prices go up on Costco, you know you're screwed. That's when you know you are screwed. The only thing that has gone up recently is the churro. It went from $1 to $1.25. But even one of those items going up has shown you that inflation is real. And it's hitting you. For the smaller things, you have to notice with other companies, like the way Pringles are shaped now, for example. The amount of air you get in the Lay's potato chip bag. Fun stuff like that. But anyway, this is round 2. This is going to be... some sort of, I think, going off of a road here, so either the valley or something else, but I love San Agasta. It's one of my new favorites. So we'll see how things go. Hopefully they'll start the round momentarily. Inflation check using cans of Arizona iced tea. Yeah, that is another way you can check inflation. I think it went up recently, right? It was like $1, now it's $1.25.
Send in Goat Team 6 now.
It hurts.
Have a good stream. Also tell Bloodwing Game that I said hi.
Hotshot, thanks for the 6-month resub. You got it, my man. I hope you keep enjoying the operations. I do hope you get a nice kick out of this scenario. By the way, quick announcement as well. Tomorrow at 1 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, we'll be having an Operation Trebuchet themed, a.k.a. Halo Pay for Pay. We have Innies, we have Covenant, and we have the Flood. If you want to take a look at that, you can look at exclamation point menu. I'm not fully done with the menu yet. I still have to add a section to help the player base. I'm going to let them buy some Warthogs and other aircraft slash vehicles to help them out. But otherwise, yeah, that'll be fun. I'm debating letting them buy an A-10, in which case I might have to set up some specific static turrets. But Arizona T didn't go up? Okay, I could have sworn I saw cans of them being sold for $1.25 instead of $1, but... I guess I was wrong. Or that might have just been to a local place instead. Who knows? Or a knockoff friend. But anyway, Mountain made this mission with Bill Nye the Science Guy. Falcon is playing tonight. Yes, that was a shocker to even me. He did a slight name change as well. But if I were to sort by names here, his name is in brackets. Pinoy Power Falcon. Arizona Tea actually stops selling to that entire company if they sell above the listed retail price. Got it. Wow, that's crazy. Hey, some people are really competitive about their prices. And when businesses compete their prices, customers win because they end up having to pay less for the product. Because if they do it the other way, where all companies solely increase their prices, that is, I forget what violation of law that is, but it's illegal, and then the government busts you. Oh dear, Falcon sent me some more pokes. It's funny because I headshotted 10 on my screen, and GF said, "You shot him in the face, WTF. I'm glad I have someone to share my suffering with now. At least my GF believes in me. Why the F woke up 3 times after being shot?" See, I'm happy for Falcon because he's starting to get his life together. He's starting to realize what's important. And he's shifting away from, you know, just being a bit of a sweat on Arma 3 to actually having fun with his life now. So I'm happy for him. It's similar to what I experienced in high school when I met Bloodwing after my ex kind of decided to screw me up. But anyway, started the mission. Made by Mountain. Oh, we got a big thing here. All right, background. In Honduras, cartels have initiated a civil war and have, after they launched a failed coup to overthrow the U.S.-backed Honduran government, a well-armed force of a small contingent of these cartels has found themselves comfortable with a couple of man pads on the approach to a large civilian airport and has successfully targeted multiple aircraft. When a C-130 bringing food and medicine with 5 American souls on board was shot down, the President of the United States ordered SEAL Team 4 to address the situation. Area of time: Honduras, Central America, 2010. Notes: Blue 4 X-ray is a contingent of a well-concealed U.S. Air Force Special Reconnaissance Operative Team. They cannot teleport anywhere. They are free to act independently of Blue 4 Platoon Leader. Since the closest naval presence in the area is USS America, the United States Marine Corps, under operational command of Blue 4 Platoon, will be providing air support. Mission rules: Green 4, a.k.a. Infor, may not move the 9K-38 turret more than 10 meters from its initial position. Helis may take off and proceed to the edge of safe start boundary before the mission begins. All right, game mode. There are 2 caches to destroy. If there is only one overtime conditions here, if one cache is alive and the attackers are near it, it may go to overtime. Nice. I'll show you guys what that means on the map in a second. Otherwise, standard 50-minute round with a 15-minute safe start. Max view distance is 1,200 meters, a little longer than normal. Usually the normal is about to click. No magnified optics nor NVG equipment, and build points are 50 points below normal. Normal is usually 125. Medium anti-tank settings. Both sides get 2 AT rounds and 1 AG round. Neat. Which is hard to tell because the small rounds are identical for AT and AG, but there's always the HE rounds are listed second compared to the AT rounds, which is nice. Blue 4, our modern American Navy AOR camouflage. To break it down, platoon leader, sergeant for the platoon, squad leader, team leader, auto rifleman assistant. They get the light machine gun. Assistant has his ammo. Grenadier IR, which has the hunt IR rounds. You fire a 40mm round in the air. It turns into a camera with a parachute. You can then connect to that camera and see anything below as it drifts in the wind. If you shoot the parachute, it falls faster. But it's a great reconnaissance tool. Machine gunner, who gets the medium machine gun, machine gunner assistant, combat engineer, light anti-tank, medium anti-tank 1, medium anti-tank 2, and their assistants accordingly, because you can have two different types of medium anti-tank. That's why there's two listed here for Mat 1 and Mat 2. Otherwise, back to the uniform here. You have the recon infantrymen and then the recon infantrymen scouts, which have the suppressed guns. Designated marksman, which for Blue 4, that appears to be a Mark 11, 20-round marksman rifle chambered in 7.62x5.1 NATO. I list it here because it's not listed in the loadout settings, and you got the sniper, that's part of recon. Crew lead, crewmen, pilots, medics, and then the base kit. Loadout for Blue 4 is going to be the Mark 18 Mod 1 with a change in stock depending on which player you are. And then the Glock 17 as a secondary. Light machine gun is going to be the M249. Medium machine gun is going to be the M240 Gulf, which go to the auto riflemen and the machine gunners, respectively. Light anti-tank is going to be an M136 single-shot disposable AT launcher. Snipers get a choice of an M2010 with a few different camo schemes. Surprise shooters get a choice of Mark 14 or a SOCOM 16. Both are 20-round NATO battle rifles chambered in 7.62x5.1 NATO, similar to the Mark 11. And then crew and aviation either get the MP7 submachine gun or the Mark 18 Mod 1. Nothing in crew-served weapons. Assets include the SOCOM Humvee that has the 50 cal and the SOCOM Humvee that has the minigun. I think that's actually the minigun version. This is the M2 version. So that's the 50 cal, and this is the minigun version because it has the M134. You have the MRZR. There's 10 of them, actually. Interesting. And then you have an unarmed Venom gunship, which is just a souped-up Huey. And then you have an actual Venom gunship. They have no weapons and no side weapons whatsoever, so it's simply a scouting Vic. And then you have this one, which has the side door guns, 4,000 rounds each. That's a lot of ammo. Usually it's down to 2,000 for that. And then they have flares to flare off the Igla rounds. Otherwise, looking at everything here, Holton is going to be ground commanding. Ilmanek is going to be leading X-Ray up there. He has Mike as the medic, Good Time Saddam taking the sniper rifle, McKenzie and Azuki both as the suppress shooter, taking the Mark 14 EBR, and then Donner being the 2IC with the Mark 18 up there. Montgomery leading Alpha, Bates as a crewman, probably taking one of the SOCOM Vics, a dedicated driver or gunner for it. Alpha 1's being led by Sholin with Appa, Brady, Herb, Carlson, Gurr, and Gordon. Kevin leading Alpha 2 with Colin, Bacon Flavored, Ivan, Olaf, Fez, Goose, and Batty. Bravo HQ being led by Cosmont. So Cosmont's leading the two Bravo teams. Bravo 1 being led by Drake with Anderson, Maz, Fist, Poe, Meldon, and Martin there. And there's no Bravo 2. Charlie HQ has Mountain leading. Spikey and Falcon, I think, were part of a Charlie element that then merged into Charlie to form a three-man team. And then Delta has merged a group with him under HQ, so it's Banks leading Ace, Waldo, Swola, Despo, Puma, Fred, and Steve. And then we have one vehicle crew for Hotel, which indicates it's an air asset. Any hotel crews are usually flyers of planes or more usually helicopters. My bad. God, I stumbled that. My bad. But it's Schnuffles with Artisan and G-Legs, which tell me they're going to take the armed one, so they have a pilot and then both door gunners. And it's funny because they have a picture of a hind on their side. And then Schultz going to be flying the other helicopter. But since he doesn't have a co-pilot to access his camera, it's going to just kind of be, you know, a dud. Not a dud. I guess a distraction. Bates. You can pick the word. But otherwise, that is it for Blue 4. And then you got the reconnaissance team all the way up here. And their position is known. Otherwise, they're camped up right here. And they have a different camo scheme as well. Nice little extra feature. Otherwise, Green 4. Down here, a little bit of a fortified area. Let's go ahead and cover them. Green 4 uniforms are going to be the Altus camouflage kits. Interesting choice, but I can see why they did it for these cartel members. They get G3s and M4A1s. Interesting combo. So that is a mix of, I believe, 7.62 by 51 and 5.56. All right. Glock 17s for the secondary, 249s and MG3s, respectively, for the light machine gunner and medium machine gunner. Also, there wasn't a designated marksman, so I'll have to go fish for that after I name everyone. Otherwise, same light anti-tank weapon, the M136 single-shot disposable AT launcher, M40A5 for the sniper, and then a Mark 14 EBR or a slightly older version of the Mark 14, which has the older, you know, woodland stock, woodstock. And then an MP7 or an M4A1 PIP for the crew or aviation. Nothing on crew-served weapons. Their weaponry include a little sit-down Igla chair, two M2s with the shield up. I'm not going to be able to see if they have the sight on them. They do have the holographic sight. All right. So they're a little easier to aim at that point. Malin, if you're listening, I think you should tell them about the Igla chair, because I could have sworn they weren't allowed to move it more than 10 meters, and I don't know where it was, but they do have it picked up right now, so I'm not sure what they're doing with it there. I will check TS. I saw him poking me. I just got to cover all of this stuff. Otherwise, four transport trucks, the BRDM, two SUVs, which are the vanilla ones, not the modded ones with the up armor glass, and a static Dishka. Interesting. All right, looking over at the forces here. Patriot leading Arctic Ghost as the platoon medic. Guy Fury leading X-Ray with Flux as the medic. Elec taking the sniper. Bayant and Tender Bane are taking the suppressed guns. I'm trying to see. I mean, they're both Mark 14s. No, Bayant is the 2IC, which means Michael is the other suppressed shooter. All right, and they're both going with the Mark 14 EBR. That's fair. They're both Mark 14s. But otherwise, Vagrant leading Alpha. He has merged the other groups with him. So he's got Grav, Sivan, Lennox, Mito, Lurch, Nemesis, Atanius, Resent, My Love, Mittens, and Coleman Eric together. Xandu leading Bravo HQ. He has merged all Bravo under him. So he's got Killer Wolf, Ralph, Rob Wolf, Z Thomas, Gibius, Holapa. That's it. Selvik, Funny Man, Jabby, and Dooley with him. And then BRDM crew is going to be Black Fox, Shigami, Shaggy, and Alex Hood. I don't think they need a three-man team for it. I think it's better if they have a two-man team personally, but that is their choice. Otherwise, two cache sites are going to be as follows. The first one up here, this little custom built-up area. Cache is going to be in this building specifically. And then all the way back here, which is where the planes have been crashing. Wow, that's cryptic, actually. But yeah, no, they're outbound on this runway, and then they're shot down right there, and they crash land in here. That's really... really cryptic. All right. Well, then. Isn't that something? Ah, they've done the thing where they're dragging the turret while they're bringing it around. But anyway, let me go ahead and talk about what Falcon's messaging. So Falcon poked me saying, so Mountain's having the pilot sling load us and dropping us. This can't go freaking wrong. So Mountain, I believe, is commanding Blue 4. No. Wait. Yep. Mountain isn't flying, though, so I'm a little confused on what he said, but I think Blue 4 is planning on sling-loading vehicles. Which, I guess, I can see that making sense. But, I mean, he's got Schnuffles and Schult flying, which... well... here's the thing about pilots in FNF. Sometimes they do crash land, and it's kind of funny, but I could see them air towing these, but that's a difficult call, but I don't know. Because you got the bottleneck right there of, you know, if this bridge goes up or, you know, something explodes right here and blocks it, then they're kind of screwed on the vehicle side. So airlifting isn't a bad call, but, oh man, it's a messy one to say the least. So Green 4 is going to go for holding out this one AO. They're not going to split between two. I do agree with that decision because it's only about 70 people on tonight. So I don't have the numbers to hold both. But, I mean, around here, they can really deploy forces around. The one caveat they're going to have to worry about is the Blue 4 X-Ray Sniper Team. So that's going to be completely dependent on how good the sniper is, which I believe is Good Time Saddam, who's actually not a bad shot. So... this could go either way, and then there's a 1,200-meter render distance, which, I mean, let me calibrate this so I can just barely see the mountaintop over there. So about to there. It's going to be about 1,200. So this is Blue 4 to that far mountain there. It's actually going to be... Yeah, roughly this render distance. So from right here, I mean, they can actually start picking people off, which is a little worrisome. But that rifle firing at maximum range, about over a kilometer, I don't think he's going to hit much. Might spook him, though. But I'll be curious to see what Blue 4 does for its airlifting. And where did that Igla turret go? Because again, it says in the rules here that it's not supposed to be moved more than 10 meters from its original position. So I feel like the original position would be like right here or something up here. But this looks to be additional fortifications. So maybe it was over here, but now I can't find it, which makes me believe they loaded it in this Vic. But yeah, I don't know. Now I got to be careful with... As I was going to say, now they got to be careful with the SUVs because it's really hard to break them sometimes, and this is what might freaking happen. That's the second time I've done that tonight. That's kind of spooky, because normally I don't do that. thankfully, there's still a minute left on save start. Otherwise, that could have potentially blown up the Vic and killed them, and they... Oh, guys. They're going to kill themselves. I swear to God, they just rear-ended that car. They're going to kill themselves. I am calling it now. They are going to kill themselves with these SUVs. Which means they're probably not going to kill themselves because I've been on opposite day today. Gosh, I don't know what's worth watching. That or the fact that they're going to sling load some of these Vics. They did say in the mission dev that they could also redeploy these Vics, but it looks like they're gonna not do that here. Let's go ahead and watch X-ray. Mission has started. Oh dear. Helicopter's going to ride the northern boundary, probably to back cap that one. And the Igla's been brought up all the way over here. Oh my God. Yeah, so they're going to be on the northern edge, so they probably won't be able to get a lock on there. Meanwhile, MRZR was up there. They're using it to drive around because of this massive border. Oh, man. This is why you recon where you're gonna land before you land there. He's gonna blow up. How did you take two Igla rock? You're still on fire, so he's... No surprise there. Again, I don't think they were technically allowed to move the Igla because it said in the rules that they weren't supposed to, but there's that blowing up. And he's dead because I don't have a marker for him. So he walked away from it, but it wasn't far. So that is, let's see, King died. Ah, because they're fighting with X-Ray over here now. Guy Fieri's also dead. Looks like they smoked that Vic, though. So it's X-Ray v. X-Ray, and they somehow run into each other. The Vic is literally tipped over. And you have another portion of fighting happening over yonder. And then you have the remains of the Force suppressing the top of this hill. I don't think that's how physics works. You know, I could be wrong, but I don't think that's how gun barrels pointing at things are supposed to work. Could be wrong. I'm no expert. But I feel like... I feel like it's wrong. You know? Based off of where the tracer's going and where he's actually pointing. See, now he lowers it. Does this mean he's gonna, like, fire into the ground now? We are 4 minutes in, by the way, and... a lot has happened. Falcon isn't bitching in our chat, which means he's still alive, by the way, at least I think. All of X-Ray for Blue 4 is dead. No, the rules were quite clear. It says 10 meters from its initial location. Doesn't say anything about a time limit for it. Besides, it was moved instantaneously, so. I don't know, maybe it means they can't move it once they've deployed it somewhere. That could be another potential thing, but I don't know, weird. Wow. BRDM just got nailed. That was about an 800-meter shot. Good shit. So it looks like a 50 cal cooked off a Humvee. Oh no, that's just part of the texture. I thought that was black smoke. I'm like, oh damn. I feel like some angles are slightly off. Alright, so Blue 4 looks like they're moving over to that position to at least those two guys are. They have AT, so they would be able to blow that cache up. The rest of these guys have to maneuver. And then you got Green 4 starting to set up some lines here, throw some grenades over at Blue 4 coming up. Ooh, a lot of miniguns here. AT fired. I think that hit. I don't see any damage though, so it might have been a near miss. Otherwise, they're quickly pulling away. Grenades going off, taking out some dudes. I mean, yeah, grenades are great for this combat. Kentucky windage. I mean, there's just so much going on everywhere. It's really hard to nail it all down. I'd imagine Green 4 is at a slight advantage because I feel like more Blue 4 have died than Green 4 at this point. But even then, Blue 4 had the number advantage, so I think Blue 4 still outnumber Green 4. So I think that's a PSG-1 for the marksman rifle. But also the G3 is making the same sound of that 7.62x5.1 caliber. So I got some other green four up here trying to engage. And a marksman got picked off, which honestly is a great person to hit, but now I think Montgomery might try to pick that marksman rifle up. Ooh, AT hit, and that was the techie. And there is the body, who's slowly drifting into the techie. Oh, no, he stopped. The techie was hungry. So at this range, it doesn't matter how good your optic is. You're suppressing. You're not gonna hit him. You're just suppressing. So Blue 4 still desperately trying to push up this area. Green 4 pulling their forces back further up the ridge as that fire continues to cook off. Blue 4 Swole has disappeared. So I don't know if he got sniped or what, but maybe he folded back with this force. But yeah, Blue 4 hits that cache. I mean, at this point, they might be going for an elimination play, but now you got that minigun firing. Excuse me. And they're still trying to push up this position. I'm surprised no one's come up and mined this. I feel like this would have been a great call to mine. You just have Green 4 desperately defending this ridge here. But Blue 4 is going to come up and eventually flank this position. So these guys are pretty much just drawing as much fire as they can. Decent GL shot. But now they're pulling back, and I think the gunner of this Vic got hit. Yeah, so he's folded in. Now the rest of the squad's pulled up here. And at this point, this Vic is just trying to be a distraction. Because the main Vic already blew up. That's why Artisan's on the ground, for example. So, why did they land the vehicle that was armed with the infantry instead of landing Choltzvik? Some of these decisions, man, I never understand. Because now they don't have any air support to speak of because it got shot down. I'm also really surprised they didn't do magnified optics for this AO. I feel like this would be a great AO for magnified optics. You got a Smog trying to range up to this Vic here. That's gonna be off to the left. Yeah, they're trying to hit that Humvee. I mean, the AT shots have been mostly on point. We've had some near misses as well. You know, considering the ranges at least, but some have been right on target the first time. Some have been a little missy. Oh god, there's the minigun coming. Oh, way short. I have to assume they're out of AT. Do you have a scope G3? No, that's a red dot CCO68 sight. Eagle, it's going all right. Just a few weird decisions for this one, but overall it's going all right. So now Blue 4 are a little defensive here because past this area where they're, you know, stopping their forces, they are really exposed moving up to that position. So they have to basically hold and engage here. And Green 4 knows it, so they're turning their attention to engage forces in the low ground. But you've got these nice little roving parts of the hill here that allow Blue 4 some instantaneous cover, even from that area. Because this hill is so rigid in its terrain, it gives Blue 4 better cover compared to it just being smooth. So Green Four repositioned all the way over there for their X-ray team. Chult just blindly flying around to draw fire, but no one's really falling for it because everyone has something to shoot at a different angle at this point. But yeah, so this position is getting sandwiched a bit because they have a force to their west and to their east. So they're pretty much pinned up here, but they are picking off who they can because some players are a little too exposed here as they push up and engage. And then you got this defensive position around the actual objective, which is this cache, holding the Humvees at bay, and they also have an overwatch point up here. I guess that M2 Vic was driven down. I thought I heard it, but no, I'm just hearing the Dishka firing, because the Dishka's also turning and engaging. So there's just a lot of fire everywhere at this point. There's a lot of different flanks going on. This is really surprising because the player count for FNF has been the lowest it's been in a while, but you're still having a lot of action on multiple different fronts here. Everywhere, it seems pretty much everyone is in contact other than X-Ray. And now you got Artisan coming up to the cache, which is somewhere in one of these buildings, actually in this one right there. But I don't think he has the equipment to actually blow it up on his own, but at least he's gonna get that done and then move in. But yeah, we're only 15 minutes into the round. Well, technically 14. And this has been an intense firefight. I really don't know what angle to watch here because there's just so much contact everywhere. Green 4 appears to be losing men up on this hilltop. They're down to 6 people on the ridge itself, 2 people on the side of the ridge. There were more. You see the body stacking as Blue 4 is able to lick from both sides here. But Blue 4 also taking casualties because as they engage the top of that hill, they expose themselves to their southern flank. And that force from both the south, direct south and more southeastern sides are firing down here, providing little opportunity for Blue 4 to take good cover from this attack vector. Meanwhile, that ridge side is starting to push infantry up because these guys have pulled back a bit, focusing on the far back. But based off of their angles, they haven't been able to see Blue 4 push up in this direction. So now Blue 4 is trying to shift to get the rest of their forces up there, but that might create a gap to allow Green 4 to take them out as they maneuver, or at least realize they're pushing around that direction and then reposition themselves and stop the front force. And then the Humvees coming up are being engaged. Ground Command himself is trying to stop the Humvee with the GL, but it is up and armored. The gunner has turned in as well. He quickly folds in there as well. So with the Humvees pushing up, they could dismount and flank, but now you got some of the shooters right here shooting at them. Now they're pushing probably back there to get out of harm's way. Meanwhile, the rest of Blue 4... Oh, wait, no, they might have actually pulled out of this Humvee. Because you got a dead gunner in there, and they're still coming around. But now you got X-Ray over here trying to flank at Blue 4, firing over here, but here we go. We got Blue 4 getting right on top of this Green 4 position. You have a freshly killed guy right there because he's still ragdolling. Oh my gosh. And Fez can't line up a headshot as his battle buddy over to the left gets killed, but he threw a grenade right on top of a Green 4 guy. That kills him. And now it's just up to Goose here. Goose, he's bandaging. Use bullet. Use bullet, Goose. Goose, bullet. Bullet, Goose. Goose. Bullets. Goose. Goose, he literally has a different colored helmet than you. Goose. Ah, Goose. 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 My friend. Well, Goose is dead. How to use this thing? I don't know. This position up here has been mostly scuffed. There's only one guy left. X-Ray have gone down and taking the 134 Humvee. They're trying to shoot down the remaining Venom gunship. Cash on the left side might have been found by Artisan, but he's still looking around. I don't know. Blue 4 meanwhile around here, they've regrouped the M2 Humvee to cover this group. All right, you got the rest of Alpha 1 now pushing up. They're being led by Sholin. Sholin knows how to kill people. As he kills one, then has to reload because he runs out of ammo. Smoke grenade going out. As Sholin gets the second kill, Herb trying to flank to keep them pinned. Ooh, you got Olaf over here. Will he find Lurch? Well, Lurch gets lunched, or mulched, however you want to say that. And that is Olaf's first kill, but it didn't count it for him for some weird reason. Morganade's going into that bunker. This body was already here from a guy that already blew up into a previous attack. Satchels go off and kill everyone except for Sholin. So his two battle buddies up there get blown away. Gurr, who was a little further down the mountain, survives because he stopped the combat loot. Look at that. Combat looting saves you. Oh, I saw the kits. Yeah, it's fun. Olaf. Kill him. Lennox gets shot, Hillary Clinton style. And now he needs to be executed, and he does. Meldon overwatching here. M2 Vic coming up. I wonder if Papega, yeah, they're going to come up with the this Vic. I wonder why it's so slow. It's picking up speed. It is a really heavy lunchbox anyway, so not surprised with that one bit. Oh, I was about to say, if that actually hits him, that would have been a beautiful GL. Oh my god, they're desperately pushing up with this Vic. Another cash still hasn't been taken out. Gee, oh my god, it's dead. It's dead. No! Oh, it still wounds him. I would have laughed my ass off if a friendly grenade went over and killed their ground command. Actually, it's not ground command, it's a vehicle commander, but I digress. And you shall receive. And he just... Friday Night Fights is a perfectly wonderful PvP game with exactly zero friendly fire incidents since the last session, as in just now. There have been zero Friday Night Fight instances of friendly fire for the past 30 seconds and counting. See, the worst part is Selwick just fucking brought Black from the dead. He literally picked him up with a pickup animation, and he... Alright. Friday Night Fights does not support any necromancy. For legal reasons, we have to say that, anyway. I don't know. This is a new one. I've written down too many highlights, guys. Let's have some normal FNF for once. Like that, see? Patriot blowing some dude's face off. That's normal. Bacon-flavored Ivan blowing up an M2 Humvee to kill off an enemy. That's normal. Jamie gets the negative vehicle kill, but he gets the friendly enemy infantry kill, so that's normal. Swola coming around with a few guys to go blow up the cache. That's normal. They'll be back in like 5 to 10 minutes. What the hell exploded over here? Is that Humvee? Wait. Yeah, You know, what's the likelihood of the first helicopter getting shot down in the same place as the second helicopter?
What?
What? That's not normal. There's no English here. How did the second one blow up? Did he land too hard? Oh, right. It was Cholt flying. My bad. All right. In a world where Cosmonaut is the closest guy to the cache, he has one mission to eliminate at least half a dozen Green 4 defenders. Will he do it? Or will Patriot magically find him and eliminate him? The game begins. There is no Igla, though. The Igla was down, like, over here, and now it's gone. So I don't know. But anyway, let's begin. Cosmonaut up a kill as he slowly moves to the construction site. Friendly Blue 4 are pinning things down. Meanwhile, Bayant is over here with a suppressed SOCOM 16. And a DMR site. And he misses his opportunity. Anyway, back to Cosmonaut. Cosmonaut slowly breaching in with grenades. He has a Green 4 member here looking around, all concerned. But Cosmonaut gets the kill, only to be killed by a guy that gets knocked unconscious, and I don't know who knocked him out. Okay, I'm done. I'm done. Stick a fork in me, I'm done. You know, the really crazy part is Blue 4 might still win this. It's a number advantage. In a world where the machine gunner buries his legs underground because that's what cover means to him. He does his best to try to blow Dreek's face off because he's already eliminated Fist, but he could still wake back up because he's only unconscious. All right, I'm done. I swear, I'm done. I'm sorry. Please tell me you found the cache. All right. Well, that'll get destroyed in a second. We'll see a notification come up for that. All right, who's up here now? Oh, yes! Yes! You have light anti-tank! You have light anti-tank! Yes! 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 Shoot him! Shoot him! What are you? Shoot him! It sets you to invincible when the round officially ends. That's why, but... Okay. Golf clap. Golf clap. Sarani. It's an ad sector. I'm going to land us further up there. Literally easy objectives. And failed set. Oh my god. Falcon with the sass. Oh, baby. Blue 4 somehow won that. Okay. I still have to wait 3 minutes before I can run the next intermission, so let's start changing the commands. So. Oh. Spikey now giving me a host. All right, so I'm assuming Spikey is done for the night, so I'll take her off of the multi. Spikey, if you're here, how's Platts? I hope he's doing okay. He never calls anymore, and I don't see him in TMTM, so. Just making sure he's okay. Otherwise, map is going to be Sarani. And a reminder, after we're done with the stream, we'll do another intermission and transfer to DayZ. With some audio snippets, I'll be messing around in Electro. And, what was I going to say? Yeah, we're going to try to repair our Kraz because it got scuffed because I desynced into a bridge and the bridge ate my front wheels and broke my spark plug and radiator, which was fun. Mission is going to be... This is round three. Where... Op 4 is attacking 3... Is attacking 3 green 4 sectors in sequential order. Op 4 has a, what's the number advantage? 10% numbers advantage. 10% numbers advantage. Their side has any assets. Infantry only. Okay. He's on leave. That's why. Yeah, because he's active Air Force. I forgot. And yeah, with military stuff, I wouldn't be surprised. Your stream just deleted itself? Ooh. Big sad. All right. I'm going to be right back. I want to fill my water glass because it's nearly empty and we still have a lot of streaming to do tonight. So I'll be back in a minute. No, it should be listed as NA. That's what it says in the title, so I don't know. Maybe I'm crazy. Who won? The attackers. Because they booped the caches in quick succession. Oh, Falcon's calling it for the night. I guess he had enough. Check TS, nerd. Yeah, you haven't said anything new. You just talked about the mountain landing. Oh, there we go. He just poked me with a clip. Is this you dying to the alleged invisible wall? In which case, I laugh at you.
What are you not bullshitting? Falcon!
Oh my god! Here, go watch that. That's hilarious. I think that's Spiky too. Oh! Oh, that's brilliant. Alright, BRB, I need to go use the Beautiful. Just beautiful. Oh, Falcon's bag. Oh, man. I love this job. Well, guys, we have a few minutes before they go into the next round. It's infantry only, so I assume it's going to be a quick one. I'm trying to think. Serrani could be anywhere on the northern or southern side. It's not United Serrani, so the barracks and military areas are going to be intact. But I guess we'll find out what the AO is in a second. But otherwise, what I, again, plan to do for the rest of the night is we're going to do a bit of DayZ with some audio jump scares. I'm going to try to do that till 11:30, 12-ish, and then we're going to do about an hour to 2 hours worth of mission dev for finishing up the pay-for-pain dev. I want to build the AOs, finalize the document, finalize any specials, any custom compositions that I can think of. Maybe a few crazy insurgent Vicks, but we'll have to see. And then I still have to build the Starship Trooper file for the Starship Trooper community. And I'm just debating how I want to do that. So we'll go from there. Ah, right, I can't see the map. SCP Kraz and Pay for Pain. How would I build the Kraz, in all honesty? That's a really good question. Because I could. I could make a Kraz, because I think we have a Kraz texture. Because we're also using some RHS assets. I could turn it into a truck technical and give it some really OP weaponry. That'd be funny. Because different, I have a feeling if I were to price that at, like, you know, 50 or 75, you'd probably. Knowing you, knowing how much you've pushed for the Kraz. I could probably make it cheaper, though. I just have to think, like, we need a battle truck technical, and that'll be our SCP Kraz. Speaking of which, expect SCP Ops to start making a comeback in July. I've got a few ideas planned for the Sunday Ops after the two horror ops I have planned. The first one being a simple Spooky Police Op, and then the Amanas Op, and then I've got a stream of SCP Ops I've been writing. But anyway, let's go ahead and go over our tactics here. So, our briefing here, this is a mission made by Puma. Russian mechanized army units are ambushed, attempting to secure the Southwest Road into Parazio. The rebel forces unleash their limited arsenal to completely destroy the enemy assets. Both sides rally their survivors to continue the battle for control of the road. Area of Operation Samato serves as the rebel HQ, rebel forces HQ, excuse me, and has fortified that part of the city. Hiccups. Notes. A convoy of wreckage litters the road near Gulan. And outside Samato, rebel forces have fortified parts of the city near Samato. Okay. Sequential capture, no vehicles. Game mode. Sequential sector, so one sector has to be captured at a time. And there are three sectors total. 780 meter distance, 150 points for the fortifiers to probably defend Samato, or at least make the fortifications there. No magnified optics, nor NVG equipment. Medium anti-tank settings. Independent get an HE round with their two AT rounds for the RPG-7s. Op 4 get only two AT rounds for the RPG, which I guess because they've reset explosive damage to actually be explosive damage instead of nerfing it like they have in the past. I guess AT rounds are all right, you know, for like building clearing and stuff, but I would have liked to see Op 4 also get an HE round to make it a bit more even here, but I guess, you know, defender's advantage. Did Falcon just, yeah, okay, he's flying around again. Otherwise, focusing on Op 4 first. up for our Modern Russian Army Desert EMR Camouflage Kits. I'm going to define what these all are. This is Platoon Leads Kit, Platoon Sergeants, Squad Leaders, Team Leaders, Auto Riflemen, Auto Rifleman Assistants, Grenadier IR, which means they have the Hunt IR rounds, little 40mm grenade launcher rounds that you can fire into the air that turn into a camera with a parachute, and you can connect to it and basically look around. It's a little eye in the sky. It has a regular camera mode and night vision camera mode, but no thermal. Otherwise, you got your machine gunner assistant, combat engineer, the guys that plant mines or throw explosives or plant explosives, light anti-tank, medium anti-tanks, one and two, because you can diversify, you know, make one AT, one AA if you want to, depends on the mission maker. Recon infantry scouts that have the suppressed guns, designated marksman, which appears to be an SVD for Op4. I bring that up because it's not mentioned in the loadout. You got your sniper kit, crew leader, crewmen, pilots, medics, and then the base kit. Loadouts for these guys are going to be AK-74M, which means modern, and then AKS-74s, which are technically submachine guns. And then you got the MP443 as the secondary, and then support weapons here. You have the RPK for the auto rifleman, the PKP for the machine gunner, respectively. Late anti-tank is going to be the single-shot disposable RPG-26. Recon is going to get the T5000 sniper rifle, and then suppressed shooters, the two scouts, get a choice of the AKS with a 45-round magazine or an ASVAL. Both are suppressed, the ASVAL being integrally suppressed. Otherwise, crew and aviation get a choice of the AKS or the PP2000. Crew, serve weapons, nothing in there, and no assets. Players for this final round is going to be Vagrant commanding the attack here. Blam as his 2IC, Grav as the medic, Kevin leading X-Ray, with Waldo as the medic still loading in because he's naked, Colin as the sniper with a T5000, Arctic Ghost as the 2IC, Goose taking the AKS as the first suppress shooter, and Batty going with the ASVAL 20-round 9x39 magazine. Fez being the group's medic, but it looks like he was another group's medic and he's merging with this group now. Interesting. Ilbnek leading Alpha HQ with Waldo, Azuki, Donner, Atanius, Holton, Saddam, and Mike under him. King leading Charlie HQ. He's got Falcon merging with him and Fred, and then Charlie 1, which I believe will merge with Charlie HQ because that's the general strategy for the community Pepega Pirates, which is where most of these guys are from. Has Flux, Michael, Dooley, Band, Illich, Swola, and Guy Fieri with them as well. Really good players in there. And then Delta's merged everyone. Xandu is leading the group with Selwick, Funnyman, Resend, Rob Wolf. Yeah, it is Rob Wolf. Gibius, Jax, Black Fox, Ralph, Killer Wolf, Shaggy, and Hulapa. That's it. Otherwise, looking over to Green 4. Let me go ahead and actually look over at Green 4 here. Ooh, this is going to be a long walk. That's a click and a half to go. Whew. All right, looking over. These guys are making a plan right now. Green 4's kits are as follows. Uniform is going to be, in case we couldn't read it, the 2010 Rebel French Lizard Camouflage. Then you have this breakdown down here. I'm going to scroll all the way down so I can see who the designated marksman is. It's also going to be an SVD. Loadouts otherwise are going to be AKMs and AKSs, so pretty much identical. In terms of weaponry, RPKs, PKP, RPG-20, 65,000, AKS or ASVAL, PP-2000 or an AKS. So it's pretty much a weapon mirror match here. And then nothing on assets nor crew served weapons. So let's see who is on the team. Patriot's going to be commanding the defense. Olaf is the platoon medic. Kiri leading X-Ray here. He's got Bacon Flavored Ivan as the medic. G-Legs taking the T5000 sniper. Lennox going with an AKS. And Despacito here going with an AKS as well. You can see the 45-round RPK banana mags in those AKSs. Dreek leading Alpha. Alpha 1 being led by Bridges with Fist, Martin, Medin, Maz, Cosmonaut, and McKenzie. Anderson leading Alpha 2 with Poe, Coleman, Eric, Warwick, Schnuffles, Artisan, and Puma. Montgomery leading Bravo, with Bravo 1 being led by Sholin, with Herb, Chold, Appa, Brady, Gordon, and Gurr. And you already see the AT guys are loading their HE rounds preliminarily, waiting for... before the op starts. Preliminary wouldn't be the right term to use there. Otherwise, Op4 is jumping around. Falcon's team leading, but I guess he's under Fred, so Fred's leading the charge there, so that makes sense, but yeah, it should be interesting. All right. No, Spikey, I didn't watch you drive off. Otherwise, I would have put a mental note down and probably listed it as a highlight. There was a lot going on. There were at least three different firefights going on, so I actually struggled to even cover that match properly because there was just so much going on. At some points, there were even 4 points of firefighting. So, again, it was really tough for me to cover all of that as a solo shoutcaster, so... It wasn't my best camera work, admittedly. But even I can get a little overwhelmed. So, Tough for me. This is the third round, Twins. As a reminder, you can always do the exclamation point mission command, and it will state in there what round it is. I always try to keep that up to date. Daisy server was still down. I saw that update, too. Let me go ahead and look. They have another pin in there. Oh, it's a discussion for the monthly operation. So they might still have it down because they also migrated their Arma box, and it looks like they're testing stuff out over there as well. They also updated their mod set. Interesting. So in the event the DayZ server is still down, because Frost is also taking a break and he's retired the server temporarily, yeah, they said it was going down for a moment, and they still haven't said it's going up yet. So we'll just work on pay for paying, and when it goes up, we will switch over. Or I'll just hold DayZ for tomorrow instead. But here's that road ambush. Ooh. Looking at the sector, so this is the first one. That's a lot of room for Op 4 to run. It looks like they're going to all run up on this angle, though. But that's AO1. AO2 is over here. And then the third one is all the way in the town of Yoro, which is the final sector. So I could imagine if Op 4 spawned a little bit closer, like just at the bases of the hill, because this is the edge of where Green 4 spawns. So it doesn't cover this terrain. Like, this is the most northern point. So if Op 4 were to spawn, like, here, for example, I feel like this would have been a better call to simulate the infantry run, because there's an extra, like, kilometer of distance they have to run. Which I guess gives them time to maneuver, but, I mean, if this is supposed to be Op 4 rallying their force, shouldn't it be the tail force of the convoy pushing?
We just want to die. We are running a kilometer to run.
Yeah, I know. Funny enough, I was just bitching about that.
It's okay. I have completely muted my long range. Fuck long range.
Where will you be when T-Far strikes? Oh, man. I'll be honest, though, and I'll tell Falcon this afterwards. He shouldn't come up here while I'm speaking because... Actually, no, because... If I'm solo shoutcasting, since I use push to talk, I wouldn't say anything to him while I was talking about something AO related. If I was using voice acting, I'd have a problem. However, if I was with someone like Barbarian or Dream up here and we were talking to each other about the AO, then I would say it's a no-no. But I guess since I'm not speaking into the microphone and it's not registering on TeamSpeak, I can quickly, you know, switch over, but he wouldn't be able to hear me anyway because I'm not on push to talk right now. I'm not pushing my push to talk button while I speak right now because there's no point in doing that because there's no one in here. So I thought I'd have a problem with it. Turns out I don't. So, but the concept's a little misleading for me personally. This is me just judging it as a mission maker myself because it makes it sound like Op 4 is regrouping themselves. So did they just... Oh, I think Command just did a mass teleport and brought everyone over to this corner because they are going to do a push from this position. So that's funny. That means I think X-Ray is also going to stick with them, though, which I agree with because X-Ray, they don't have the capacity to run off on their own. They should be sticking with the main force. But yeah, if Op 4 was, like, you know, down here and there was more vehicle wrecks down here, it would show that they were regrouping, which is what the story indicates. Plus, that would cut the distance down in half and make it a little quicker. But at the same time, I get it because Green 4 would then, you know, perceive that as just setting up a battle line right here and, you know... Just immediately engaging, that would force Op 4 in a tough decision position. Excuse me. So at least by doing that, this gives Op 4 more opportunity to attack at multiple different angles, which in this case, they're just going to do a clean sweep, you know, southwest to northeast on the sectors because it is a sequential fight anyway. But I don't know, just with the story, it confused me a bit. You know, I also write half-assed stories sometimes and accidentally butcher those as well, so... Not going to complain too hard. I just think it would have been a little bit easier because with infantry only, you know, running a kilometer first really does screw with the offensive team because their stamina is low and their weapon sway is going to be atrocious. So it forces them to have to stop somewhere just before they move in to regain their stamina and then move in, which I guess with a 50-minute round, it makes sense. But that gives the defenders an opportunity to spot the attack wave coming in and then brace for it. But you know me, I like things done quicker. I just don't like sitting around here and us watching massive platoon lines move. But I think they're going to triple time this, so it shouldn't take more than 5 minutes for them to get up to Sector 1, unless they then divide into like a platoon battle formation, which I doubt they'll do because they're only a few squads. Suffice to say, we will see. Excuse me. Yeah, but it looks like that DayZ server is still down. And again, I think it's because they got sidetracked because they're also working on Arma stuff and they just, you know, forgot about DayZ, which is fine. When you're dealing with so much shit, I get sidetracked all the time, so it makes sense. So we'll probably just go into mission dev and wait for the servers to come back. Because let's be honest, Friday Night Fights has ended early. It's going to end early, too, because this is round three. We just hit the two-hour mark for the stream. And usually we go, like, 3.5 to even 4 hours sometimes. So, usually 3.5, though, because the rounds go to the full time, which is, you know, 3 65-minute rounds and then 3 setup periods, each taking anywhere from, like, 15 to 30 minutes. So, that's, like, 1.5 hours at max per. So, yeah, it does sometimes go to 4 hours. You know, with the 3 o'clock branch ending around 7, and I sometimes would leave the NA branch early because it would be like 11 and the second round just ended. So second round just about to begin, 50 minutes left, which means we'll probably finish around 10:45. Honestly, with the size of this AO, maybe a little earlier. But it's going to be 5 minutes of maneuvering, up to 10 minutes at max. First sector looks to be where Green 4 is setting up their main hold here. So it could just be a battle for the first sector, and this could last 20 minutes. What I would like to see in the future, though, if any FNF staff watches this back, just to consider an idea, is if both sides are ready, there should be possibly an add action that the commander could scroll wheel. Make sure it's not the top option so you don't accidentally pick it. But something they can toggle on or off, and it gives a notification. So if green 4, let's say it's blue 4 and op 4 fighting each other. So if blue 4's commander is ready, they can turn that scroll wheel option on. It says blue 4 command is ready. And then op 4 also has the option to do that. And let's say op 4 is defending. They finish their defense prep early at the, you know, 12-minute mark, and then blue 4 already called that they're ready at the 8-minute mark. So then op 4 says they're ready, and then the round starts at that time instead of them waiting the additional 3 minutes. I think that would help speed things up a little bit. When you think about it, you know, only a few minutes here and there, but hey, you know, 6 minutes, 9 minutes, 10 minutes? That's 10 minutes of your life, you know? Instead of everyone just waiting around doing nothing. So just little things to optimize. It wouldn't be that hard either. You would just tie in the script that triggers the mission to start from the FNF framework into a, I guess, a call function of if these two options are true, then you start it automatically. And then condition or parameter one for the first condition is blue 4 command using an add action, which just states that first condition to true, and then the other side adding that add action to do it as well. Just a way to optimize. All right, otherwise, we have the Great Migration going here. At this rate, they're going to probably follow up these hills and then maybe push in from the Greenland, possibly coming all the way around and attacking from this angle where there's a little bit of concealment. Or they might go all the way around and back cap into Sector 2. That way, they have positions of cover to utilize to push up to this hill and then potentially try to hit Sector 1 from Sector 2, which normally I complain about those types of ideas, but in this sense, it does avoid a lot of the open fields. So it could work out for him. This is going to be a tough AO. Green 4 seems to be content with holding. They're sending a few scouts out to try to figure out where Op 4 is going to push from. With this all being enemy, where the enemy started, I'm going to page up a little bit just to show it. Like, all of that road right there was the start zone. A well-positioned guy just looking over and seeing that there's no movement on the open field is going to make them infer that they're either coming around the far right flank, pushing up this valley, and then getting up this way, which X-Ray is about to go capitalize on and see that there's no mass infantry movement there. Plus, that's suicide. Leading your guys in a valley where enemies can get right on the ridgeline and start shooting at you, that is suicide, especially with grenades now. Actually doing stuff. Rolling a grenade down a ridge is not rocket science. So they're going to go this way instead. Which, I'm going to be honest, really thinking about it, that's the only way they can go. But I don't think Green 4 has the manpower to capitalize on this, and they can't be certain that they wouldn't pull a play like that. Plus, they can still go all the way around on this side, riding up this little ridge, and then riding the side right here. Would that expose them? Yes, absolutely. Is it still possible because it's FNF and I've seen people do dumb shit before in this community? Or I guess group of communities that plays PvP? Yeah. What communities to play with? Do you mean my recommendations, Curie? Or who do I play with right now? If you don't mind clarifying. Because I can happily answer both. But if you want a more direct consultation, you can DM me. I can ask what you like and try to find a good place for you. And then, of course, there's always Reddit Find a Unit or the Arma 3 official Discord. Or if there's a specific mod you like World War II IFA or the Starship Trooper mod that J-Max makes, or any Star Wars mods you specifically like. Usually in their Discord, they have a section where they let communities that use that mod advertise themselves.
Let's give them a warm welcome.
Any recs for Shield Milsim? Let's see. TSB, which is the group I mainly Zeus for, TMTM, FK, KD and XX, Icarus, which is J Raptor's group, but I've heard Icarus right now is impossible to get into because Raptor's having his YouTube spike really taking off, so his popularity is spiking to the point he can't sustain all the people that want to get in on his group because... I mean, it's also how he does his videos. He does the highlight compilations that attract everyone, which is why he's getting popular. But in terms of recommendations, you know, places you could actually probably get into without a massive wait list. I mean, then again, TMTM is kind of the same way. They have a massive wait on a vetting process, but they have a really low turnover rate compared to other communities. It's Ignis. I'm sorry, not Icarus. That's, yeah. No, you're right. My bad. Thanks for the clarification, Tiberius. I'm tired. We've been streaming for, what, five or six hours now. But beyond that, links to websites? I don't have them. I can't tab out right now. You could Google. Just Google Discord links or whatnot. Or you could DM me, and I could... Because I know FK has a website, TSB has a website... TMTM, I think, has a website as well. KDNXX, I don't know, but if you go to Remy's channel, he would probably have a link because that's his main community. And Ignis, I don't know. Could someone write them out in chat for him? You don't mind. No problem. One of the jobs I feel like I have, or at least responsibilities, is anyone interested in this game, I'll help you find a place, because that's what content creators should do. TSB, TMTM, FK, Foxtrot, Kilo. Those two letters. Icarus. No, excuse me, Ingus. I screwed that up again. And then KDN, CADIAN, space, XXTH. And then, I mean, those are the only major groups I know for casual Milsim that do ops anywhere from like the 20 to 60s. And then there's always a shit ton of groups you can find on Reddit, Find a Unit, or the official Armor 3 Discord that do smaller scale stuff. But those qualities always have a weird range compared to larger groups that generally have higher quality because, you know, they're larger and they have more vetted players and yada-da. Of course, I can do my self plug. Within my Discord, we're starting to do some small scale stuff. Mainly, though, it's a lot of special forces and horror ops right now because it's stuff I can't do in TSB because it's lower player count and TSB has certain rules about Zeusing. But if you're interested in shit like that, just do exclamation point Discord and get into my community for that because that's all open sign up. I don't have any rules about that. It's like a system of if you fuck up, then you're on the radar, but until you fuck up, if you don't fuck up, then you're free to take whatever. And then I think we're having a Starship Trooper op in there soon because people wanted one. So I'll probably make like a small-scale series-style op based off of that. Turned Outpost Survival. I don't know. But anyway, focusing on the mission here. Anderson putting some GLs out there. We had some AT launched. Again, Op 4 only has AT warheads. No HE warheads. Green 4 do have an HE warhead here and there, though, so... Even though they reset explosive damage to be proper now instead of being severely nerfed with an FNF, AT is only going to be really effective in either a building or like within a meter of the guy to actually wound or kill him or direct hit. You know, 506 IR is not a casual milsim. No, they are a much more serious milsim. But yeah, milsim is a whole other beast. But if you're looking for that more serious atmosphere, that is a good one. 15th MEU is another one. But there's a lot of communities out there that do milsim stuff. There's a lot of variation for everything. But yeah, I try to keep active with most of the major groups these days just so I can get people to where they want to go. PvP-wise right now, it's FNF, OFCRA, Coalition, AFI, and then the Russian communities that blow everyone out of the water. And that's your large-scale stuff. There's groups like Electronic Sportmaster that focus on squad-based PvP, but those are the closest you'll get to esports, for example. But beyond that, let me focus on the round here. So this is the issue with what I like to call the gagglefuck formation, because people blindly charging in the smoke, firing forward, you don't know if there's friendlies or enemies in front of you, so you could very well be killing your own friends and screwing yourselves as you make this push. But look at this. So the middle formation has decided to push in. The right side formation is now charging the open completely out of the fight, and the left side is also out of the fight. So the central formation here is defeating itself in detail. Because now only a third of the force is attacking this first sector. I think they meant to have these two forces come around the flanks and assist, but now they're just getting torn up here. Which has made Green 4 have a slight number advantage here, which has made this fight that much more tough. Oh. That Green 4 guy still had to reload his PKP, so Bant was able to get a free kill. It was a little bit of a messy shot, though. So we saw a little bit of stairwell play here by Falcon, who got his first kill. That guy got picked up on the window. Bay, and I think, just got killed by Warwick. Bay is the, I would say, the best player with an FNF. Falcon, a close second. But, you know, people like Flux King, Guy Fieri, also very, very good. Definitely in my top 10. Meldon got a pick off here. Yeah, so Op4's only down to, like, five dudes in this AO because the other two flanks of Op4 decided not to push in with them. I know I missed ESM. The issue was I had IRL stuff, unfortunately. I forget what it was, but I had something IRL to deal with and I had to miss it. Which sucks because I really do like ESM. That is like the most professional stream I will ever do. And I love it. Because they really do make it feel like an official esports thing with their transitions and whatnot. But you know, certain events I have get in the way of certain things. Because Icebreaker, one of the best guys at that dev, he offered me an invite to something really, really cool. And I had to turn it down because I was hosting MCO the same day. And if it was any other MCO that I hadn't had to push back because of DDoSing issues and shit, I would have actually pushed MCO back a week just to do it. Because an invite from the man himself. Ooh, great grenade throw. But the guy heads inside before it happens, only for him to get hits. Was that? No, that was Meldon getting the kill there. Wait. Wait a minute. But that was a... But you were a friendly. But Meldon just shot a friend. Okay, cool. And then he gets blown up by a grenade. Karma. Double tap. Double tap. Please, because he could actually wake up. Double tap. Double tap. Yeah. Oh, God, the lunge. Is Falcon dead? Nope, he's still up. Still on only a kill. Now you got the southern group trying to push, but there's green four out here that are going to keep them pinned. You got some smoke grenades being fired on both sides. And then the northern push is still... They're pulling back, actually. They might have gotten lost. That's cute. Right on them. And then there's also FNF Titans that is also small scale. Yeah, there's a lot. Falcon being the aggressive little asset here. Did you almost just shoot Falcon in the face? That would have been funny. Falcon has a running meme. There was quite a few weeks in a row where he kept getting friendly fire to the point we made it a massive joke. And he got very salty about it, too. I mean, who wouldn't? But it was pretty damn funny. Otherwise, Falcon, dually, I'm not sure if he was from the southern push or if he was the northern push. Let's see. Are these guys part of Charlie? Yeah, so dually's part of Charlie. Most of them are down in here. And this seems to be, like, a lot of the really powerful players, too. You know, Bands, Guy Fieri, Flux King, Michael. I mean, anyone from the Bag of Pirates is usually pretty good. Some blind firing around here. They're going to run into each other. No, Falcon ducks into the building. It's Schnuffles. Schnuffles is not a bad shot himself. Grenade thrown. Oh! Too far. He's got to hear those footsteps. Ball is up on Schnuffles, but he takes flanking fire. Oh, Falcon, run! Falcon, you didn't hear the beep beep! The building doesn't go. He manages to knock Schnuffles out, though. He could still wake back up, though. So he quickly runs. He needs to get a double tap. That's a classic down formation. And he gets the double tap there. Falcon on three. The man's trying to carry. I got Green Four barraging that area. He's going to have to get in the cover and bandage at this point. It's going to allow Elik to have a follow-up through there, but that charge blew up on the other side of the wall. Otherwise, Elik would be dead. So it absorbed most of the blast. So Op 4 now has the southern side. They've pushed back a lot of the Green 4 defenders here. They're going to be engaging mainly with Bravo. So Op 4 still could bounce back here, despite losing a lot of their manpower. And then Alpha's going to follow in to reinforce the remains of Charlie here as these two guys continue to push. The sector, it's a 2v2 right now. Artisan trying to run up. Doesn't spot Artisan through these trees and bushes here. It's too thick. Good level of concealment. Titans is dead. Aw, I'm sorry to hear that, Nem. That's a shame. I kind of like Titans, to be honest, because you had two iterations of it, right? That is a real shame to hear, though, because that was nice. All right, so Green 4 pulling out of Sector 1. This tells these two guys that they are safe as both Artisan and Puma pull back from the sector. And now you got Green 4 also pulling back here into secondary defensive lines into Sector 2 in the town of Samato. Yeah, they built quite a few fortifications here, which is quite nice. So we got Falcon trying to pick off Artisan as he moves away. I do see a bit of blood, and I thought I saw Artisan get knocked to his feet, so he quickly picks himself up and keeps running. Meanwhile, you got two members of X-Ray over here with more dead members of X-Ray. Bacon-flavored Ivan on three kills here. Lennox trying to pull back. He is shot in the back of the head, Hillary Clinton style. I'm going to rule that as a suicide. Ah, right, Onem. That's a shame. But I get it. Maybe when FNF switches over to Reforger, because I have seen them working on that mod for Framework, it might come back. But, you know, that's all excitement to see for Reforger. I swear eventually I will start covering mod reviews weekly on the channel, but I've just been so busy with other shit. But that is something that I will eventually have to transition into, because Reforger is the future, followed by Arma 4. Artisan now awaiting Falcon out. Falcon's dead. Woo! I hate to say it, but Falcon got no. In the face! In the face! Hit him in the face! There you go. Takes three bolts to be a suicide. You'd be surprised how efficient the people in that department can be. Yeah, I know, Nem. I'm really behind on the content I wanted to cover for it. But thankfully, I'm almost done with my front log plans for the channels, which will give me the time. It's just a balance game of doing house husband stuff and front logging three channels. All right, so now we're going to see an op 4 transition here. 18 minutes into the round, round one take, area one taken. I doubt green 4 will pull back to sector 3 because sector 3 isn't as well developed as sector 2 here. There's just a lot of nice positions to work with and a lot of flanking. Shame Falcon did not survive because I think he would have done really well in this area. Falcon, I'm going to be honest, that one, there wasn't a one-way smoke, Falcon. He literally keyholed you. He was right here, and you stuck your head out right there, and he shot you in the face. It wasn't one-way smoke, man. It was fair game, because you went aggressive, and Artisan waited you out, and it was beautiful. See, there's your body. He honestly keyholed you. Yeah, because you were looking here. You were literally looking here, so of course you can't see him. Because you were looking here the entire time. I watched him do it. Now, I'm ragging on you, buddy, but I'm going to be honest, in your shoes, I don't think there was any way you could have won that fight, because he had a great spot to camp you out. But it had nothing to do with the smoke grenades. I'm so sorry. I think it's because the smoke affects our client side, so not every client's going to see the same thing, so. Oh, well. Right on, Em, I appreciate it. Let me know if it's something I'm allowed to talk about or not allowed to talk about. Marksman shot ricocheting off of a helmet, doing no damage. Or that was just a very near miss. So we're going to have about 1 to 2 minutes of maneuvering as this force comes around. That's going to alleviate that group. But at the same time, this is a lot of open area. Oh, that's going to be tough. Anything else after this match? So I was going to get on the DayZ server. DayZ server still might be down, which means I'm going to work on the Pay for Pain that we're going to do tomorrow. We'll have some more shooting here. So it's a marksman engaging each other from range. But yeah, so for the development of there's so many terms in my head, I'm sorry. For Pay for Pain, I gotta finish the document. I'm gonna go over stuff that is to help the player base, any other additional things I want to do for specials, and then build the AOs. And that should probably last about 1 to 2 hours. And if we have time afterwards, I will go to the DayZ server if it goes back up and play that for about 1 hour. How is your mentality screwed right now? You had your GF cheering you on. Go to bed. Hours of farming? Dude, send me pictures of what you're farming, man. Unless you're talking about video games, in which case, boo. Run an actual farm. That is one of my new dreams, though, is to get a plot of land in Virginia and turn into a farming YouTuber. And you know what I'm going to farm? I'm going to farm the real cash crop of America. I want to farm weed, but weed's not officially legal yet federally, so it's a risk to farm it. But, I mean, whew, a lot of profit in that. Hay baling? Hay baling's fun. It is super freaking tedious, but it can be fun for, like, the first three hay bales, and then you realize, oh my god, I need to make 100 more. But yeah, it's a pain. I'm gonna be honest though, I do not like marijuana. A THC high to me just gives me a weird freaking headache. And Bloodwing, it makes her like a, it makes her literally a schizo, which is not fun to deal with. More of an alcohol and cigars guy. Pharma 3. I mean, another thing I might do if it gets legalized, I am going to set up an indoor garden in my basement and grow weed and then sell it. All right? That's how I'm going to make my extra income. Again, we're just waiting for the Fed to legalize that bitch, and I will start it immediately. But yeah, those are my little dreams. We'll see, Falcon, because he's running an hour before mine, and I kind of screwed up on my scheduling because I meant to run Pay for Pain last week, but I ran out of time, and then I forgot Devour scheduled that thing because I thought he was running it on the day that people picked, which was the Sunday the week before, so I didn't realize he moved it. I think he told me, and I just tuned it out of my head because I thought he was already in the process of running it, but yeah, you know. Fed got bigger problems to fry recently. Yeah, just look across the pond. But otherwise, Op4 is pushing their forces in here. We have 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 people inside the sector. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 people outside of the sector. 6 plus 7, that is 13. 13 green 4 remaining. Op 4 has 3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. So Op 4 outnumbering green 4 here. I think it's just a simple number advantage. Have fun, Falcon. Go to bed. Wretched, not where I live. Ooh, Op 4 getting picked off there. That was one free kill. Like I said, I would be happy to explain it when it gets legalized, but it's something I've looked into. But it also depends on your area, who you can sell it to, blah, blah, blah. I'm getting off topic. Ooh, girl, where are you going? I just love some of these damn ragdolls tonight of these bodies just going nuts. Did Gordon not shoot his gun? Because I feel like Gordon didn't shoot his gun at all. I don't even see any blood splatter down here. What? Did he just go, oh, it's a person. Well, there's one off-four guy getting caught in the street. Keyhole by the windows here. Ooh! That was an HE rocket, and it just murdered two people and wounded a third. That's what I was waiting for. Aw, they're kissing. Don't ask how. Julie running back, trying to do attack reload. Is going to jump off the window like a boss. But Irv knows the bullshit! What is this? What is this Mission Impossible bullshit? Like, actually, what the hell is Dooley on? That was awesome. So most of Op 4 is down. You got Maz kind of running around back here. He is on, I thought that was an 8 for a second. I was going, oh, damn, but no, he has 0. So many swan dives. Yeah, right?
Oh,
painful. So Op 4's offensive ability has been neutered because of that well-placed HE rocket. Yes, Dooley's helping to bounce it back, but not by much. He actually climbed up here to bandage, utilizing a little bit of elevation. A little risky, but, you know, if people are at head level, they won't find him. It's up to X-Ray to pull in, but X-Ray always takes its sweet-ass time for this. Maz is sulking around here. He could do well. And then you have the side marksman dealing with that force. That's Puma on 4 kills. Not even a marksman here, but he's got an AK with a PKAS sight. And he is picking people off where he can. I think there was another Op 4 guy right here that got picked off. Yeah, so that was Platoon HQ trying to get a click here. Yep, double tap in the body. That's Patriot. He is on 5 kills. This could very quickly turn around. And Maz, I think, just got kill number 1 there. Might have been number 2, too. No, that's a dead green 4 guy. So that was his first one. He's just marauding around. We have this medic kind of walking around over here. This is just a game of hide and seek at this point. Yeah, so he's going to pick up. No, he keeps the SVD.
Now.
Arsenal Lupin, thanks for the 12-month resub. Welcome to the Lance Corp Club, my friend. I hope you keep enjoying the operations. And I do hope you get a kick out of Friday Night Fights tonight. It has been very brutal. Did Dooley die? Ah, Dooley ran up here and got picked off by someone. Quite possibly could have been Olaf. Because I don't see any kills on those other two guys. Or he traded with his captor. Or aggressor, my bad. Have you ever done a more heavily modded FNF? What do you mean by heavily modded? Because FNF has only done this stuff, Titans and World War II, and they also did Vietnam. Nam, you've been here for a while. That just shows how long this shit's been going. About 6 years. Ugh. Crazy. I know OFCRA has done quite a bit of stuff as well. They also did a Warhammer 40K thing for a week or two. That was really fun. Starship Trooper FNF, guys, I am not in any position to ask or request for FNF stuff. I am merely someone that spectates. I am not a staff member. And I think some of the current staff members, it's weird. Some of the staff members love me. Some of them hate my guts. And that's for various reasons of various things that have happened. And I think for all those relationships, the feeling is mutual, except for maybe one, because I don't know where he stands, but that is besides the point. Did Appa, I don't know what Appa shot at. I think it was burning a mag. Where's Pay for Pain mod set? It's in the TSB announcement. And yes, it says it's an IFA fixed mod set. That's because I accidentally misnamed it. I'll address it tomorrow when I make the op announcement. I think that's just how the internet works in general. Oh, yeah. There's people out there that hate my guts. Some have good reasons for it. Some do not. Some hate me because their friends told them to hate me. And I love meeting those people. Because I'm like, oh, that's cool. Like, why? And then they're like, they never give me a good reason. And that makes me laugh. Yeah, I'm not going to get into it, Broadshore, but yeah. I guess the only time to get pissed off is when they start DDoSing you for 9 weeks. But yeah. Yeah. Anyway, I'm going to start letting that go as time goes on, because it's like, it happened. What can you do about it? I still love how this guy died. His head's under the freaking stove. All right, people picking up RPGs. I mean, what can you do, Wayne? I think it all just stems from ideology conflicts between YouTubers, and, you know, some people see that as a problem. Personally, I couldn't care less. I think it's the older they get, the less fucks you give. Because I'm going to be honest, the only things I care about right now is the ops I Zeus and the people that play those ops actively, because, you know, their opinions mean everything to me, because that's how I get better for catering them. My mortgage payment, my bills, Bloodwing, and maintaining the place we live. Like, that's all I really care about right now. And making sure you guys have a good time, of course. Not my highest priority, admittedly, but it's important to me. Because, you know, we're all here to see this really awesome game called Arma 3 and the various different crazy things you can do with it. Like, Maz here, who's picked up an AK, and he's trying to pick off this one Op 4 guy named Jax, who's now trying to run for his life, as now we have Op 4 X-Ray finally entering the AO after taking the longest fucking route possible, because it's X-Ray. And X-Ray always pulls that shit with an FNF. And now the player count is even numbers-wise for both sides, whereas Op 4 had a pretty significant numbers advantage going in. So now it's really anyone's game. Fuck the tax, man. Oh my god. The amount of taxes I have to pay is ridiculous. Jack's getting picked off. As Patriot's now running, he's on 6 kills. Almost takes a headshot by a friendly. That would have been Maz. I would have laughed if that bullet held true. That's fine. And now he's looking around. He's double tapping more bodies to make sure. You got some Op4 guys looking down here. Patriot has to be careful as he is exposed by Killer Wolf. Except Killer Wolf isn't able to line up the headshot. He tries to run through the bushes here. Gets a shot on the chest. Quickly tries to move, but Maz manages to walk up and save Patriot by suppressing his position. And Patriot knocks him out, and Maz gets the execution shot. Now let's see grenades. There's the follow-up fire. Maz takes shots. He folds back into the bushes. Will Patriot grenade? He's on 7 kills right now. He is saving it. Let's get into the low ground here. Great grenade throw. Manages to kill 2 people. Patriot gets behind someone and eliminates him. I think that was Maz's grenade. Yep, he's up to 3. Patriot, I believe, up to 8 now. As he runs up, gets into a one-on-one, and gets mowed down by Grav. Something eventually had to give there. Grav gets the execution shot. But now Green 4 is on the counteroffensive. It is 3-on-3 up here, but Green 4 also has 4 guys in the sector. This is the end. Why is X-Ray so slow? It's just an FNF thing. X-Ray feels the need to take these massive elaborate flanks so they're not spotted, because they like to be little solo boys. Uh-oh. Oh, you're AFK, and you didn't see him because you're blind. That's beautiful. Is that Maz? 50 minutes? Yep. And Maz tries to get the kill on Batty, but Grav ends up coming down and slaying both of the people counterattacking. Now it is just up to Olaf and Appa to hold the line. Both, Appa's on no kills, Olaf on 2. Olaf is a medic, so we can self-medic and heal in the field. But otherwise, this might be the first round to actually kind of go through all the minutes if Op4 is able to smash through these 2 defensive guys, or Green 4 might chicken out and go reinforce their defensive line to force X-Ray to come in. I see that hydrate. RPG? I guess he thought he saw something up here and just fired at a ghost. So I think Grav's been doing medical on some people to make sure they're in top shape to fight. But this is a 3v6. Green 4 has a 2-to-1 ratio and defense. Wait a minute. I lied. Someone even escaped me, guys. Puma just got sniped by Colin. So it is now a 4v5. I'm going to be honest, though. If one green 4 guy runs out of this sector and makes it to sector 3 to hold, green 4 could possibly win this to time. That was a great shot, yeah. But Puma woke back up and is going to be able to pull out because Colin wasn't able to double tap, so now it's 4v6. So sniper support with Op 4 still having their three guys over here, it's going to be a long 13 minutes. So I am going to select Colin. And let's see what he can spot from this northern side as we wait for the rest of Op 4 to fold into that sector. All right, I'm going to quickly check Discord again. They still haven't put the server up. That is okay. Yeah, so I'm probably going to have to do dev work instead, which, yeah, whatever. I know you guys wanted DayZ, but it's not up, so I can't do anything. 12 minutes. Colin still looking around for that headshot. I'm also focusing on those three triangles right there, waiting for them to move in. But until they move in, it's just up to Colin to pick off as many people as he can to try to even the scales. But Green 4 can just entrench themselves in the town without worrying too much. I guess Colin's also good for being a blocking position to any Green 4 that try to run to Sector 3, because Green 4 does have an opportunity to play the clock by holding Sector 2. And then having one guy go back to Sector 3 just to hold it. But beyond that, there isn't really much to do as we enter the 11-minute mark. All right. Op 4 slowly moving off this hill. They're combat looting, which, I'm going to be honest, I can see why you would do it. They're picking up the best guns they can find because Colin can then run over to Sector 3 and cap it as soon as Sector 2 is taken. But I don't know. It's a tough call. Switching to the AKS or keeping the AK. I'm not sure if the banana mags would fork for the AKS. Oh, yeah, they are, because he can suppress it, but he's not picking up the 45-round mags. Dirty, dirty campers. I'm going to be honest, though. It's going to take 10 minutes alone to sweep this sector, so unless Colin immediately runs to Sector 3, I don't think Op 4 are going to win, even if they eliminate all of Green 4 minus one player. Now, if they kill all of Green 4, they win by default, but with Green 4 camping so many corners, I don't know how Op 4 could win this. What they need to do is just be really cautious, poke their guns in front of stuff. If they take fire, pull back and pop a nade, get a free kill. Smoke has been deployed. The charge begins. Wide GL here. Got other GLs firing just massive amounts of smoke. They're even firing flares. Artisan peeks out and gets the first kill. Now it's just up to grabbing Barty as Colin is now looking over Sector 3. See, if Colin doesn't move from that position, they are... Okay, so he's going to fold in now and make the effort. But if he just sits up there, they're probably going to call it for Green 4 anyway, because that's what they did with Sector 1 when the sniper team just stayed camping the sector. Not sure if Grav just got a kill there. There was some fire exchanged. We're down to five people in the AO, so Grav did just kill somebody. Got Appa trying to fold in here. He instead climbs. He takes shots. Gonna find Batty. And headshots Batty instantly. Woo! No fucking way. Grav, that was the luckiest fucking grenade throw I've seen all night. Aimbot with the grenades, man. Beautiful. Can Grav kill four people? We also have Colin coming in. Sniper is going to do much good in this AO, though. 8 minutes. So other blue four guys are just holding in this building. When op four have an entire sector, they got a freaking sweep. And Puma is chilling right here, relying on listening to those footsteps. So here's Colin's footsteps. Talk about being freaking deaf. Granada. Puma now trying to come around and flank. Double taps on Colin's body. Oh, Grav should have won that, but he was poking center mass, and Puma shot him in the face, and that is GG. Green 4 has won. All right. So, guys, here is the deal. I am going to switch over to mission development. One final check here on the bot to see if the server is up. It is not. So we're going to switch over to mission dev. All right. Give me one moment here. There you go. Green 4 wins. Okay. Let's go ahead and stop the recording.